So with Zone Wars on the rise, have you been wondering how the pros manage to dominate the mode with ease? Well, we're going to be talking about exactly that in this video. But your crush army, so excited to get into this. Motivation Guy is here today. We're going to be covering the best tips and tricks to dominate your opponents in Zone Wars. Zone Wars has become one of the most competitive and enjoyable creative game modes so far. And these days, there are a ton of pros wagering on the modes daily. So do you want to be able to wager with the best of them in Zone Wars? Well, after watching this video, you're gonna have all the tips that you need to know. In a game of Team Zone Wars, there are four different starting positions that you can choose from. You can just spawn in at height, mid-left, mid-right, or the low ground. Of these four, it's pretty clear that height is the most important of the starting positions. It's usually the position that brings the most to whether you win or not at high levels of Zone Wars. If you're in the height position, you need to be the most mechanically gifted fighter on your team and have to always be able to retain your position of height over your enemies. The height player usually always ends up being eliminated to fall damage after eliminating the other height player, but they also need to be doing damage right up until that moment. In other words, they need to be able to keep up the pressure on the opposing team for as long as possible to help their team win. If your team's height player can't stay alive for long enough, it can cause your teammates to get double teamed in the long run, increasing the level of pressure on your team and likely giving your opponents an easy free win. So one of the best ways, guys, to really keep hype is by knowing exactly how to build. So why not head on over to ProGuys.com to check out the Master Builder, the one and only Clicks, and our brand new Master Course. We also have pro coaches tailored to help you improve at incredibly quick speeds. Click the link down below or in the top right to get started right away. So the next two positions are mid-left and mid-right. You start off in the mid-ground, okay, which is a layer below height. Mid-ground players need to be constantly aware of their surroundings and will basically be dedicated to messing up the other team's starts. Once again, guys, being good in this position is incredibly important because it allows you to slow down the opponent's start, and it's also going to allow your height player to worry less about being shot out from below. You're going to have to be careful, though, because there are going to be a ton of strategies that the enemy mid-ground players can use against you to try and just counter your attempts to slow them down. So playing in the mid-ground is no walk in the park, I'm telling you right now, and you're going to need to be alert all the time. All right, guys, so the last and to be an honest least important position in Zone Wars is the low ground. All right, bunch of Crunch Army, like, unless you're playing in a 4v4 Zone War, you should always try to stay away from this position. You're going to be spawned at the lowest possible position, which gives you a huge disadvantage and is going to separate you from the rest of your teammates. If you spawn down on the low ground, your teammates can just simply jump down and really just eliminate you due to poor positioning. So unless you have a set strategy that's going to allow you to pull off some high level low ground, you know, shenanigans already planned with your teammates perfectly, refrain from ever spawning into the low ground. And after you figured out the perfect position that you would be the best at, you're going to need to know the optimal way to start off each round so that you're going to always manage to have an edge over your opponent in the early game of a Zone Wars match. For playing height, guys, all right, there's an easy start that basically anybody could pull off no matter your skill level, and that's the cone side jump. So to initiate this start, all you got to do is place a cone in the front of your starting box and edit it to be a sideways ramp. When your box opens up, just jump into your edited cone and do a basic side jump. Seems simple, right? Well, what this start actually allows you to do is to be an extra layer higher than the enemy team's height player. So after side jumping, make sure you land on top of your ramp to give yourself an even bigger boost. And when you've landed, you need to keep nining infinitely until you're absolutely sure that you have the high ground above the enemy high ground player. This will give you higher elevation every single time, and you won't have to waste time doing a 90 at the start of each round. Depending on what your opponents end up doing, okay, you need to have the perfect mid-ground counter strategy. So this strategy is going to have to do one of the following two things. You either need to do 50 plus damage to your opponent as soon as the round starts, or do something to disrupt the enemy height player from cranking up for height. No matter what your strats are, guys, those two things have to be your ultimate goal, okay? So a great start, guys, for a mid-ground player is the Yoldi, which basically involves you placing cones and walls as soon as the round starts towards your opponent's spawn. This will allow you to box them up before they have a chance to react, giving you guys an easy advantage over the other team's mid-ground players, which in turn usually give you a free kill, especially if your teammates works with you. So this is a bit of a higher level approach, you know, needing at least a slight bit of understanding when it comes to piece control. So if you don't feel confident enough, For the oldie, okay, you should just try to ramp up over your opponent instead, which will give your team some extra time to maintain the high ground. So before we get into the next tip, guys, so I just want to ask you our question of the day. Which pro do you think is the best creative warrior? Let us know down below. Come on now, don't be shy. Come on, let us know. So even though Zone Wars is a team game mode, like whether it's a friendly match or a wager, you're going to have to treat every position that you play in as a 1v1. As such, like you can't let yourself lose your 1v1 without ensuring that your opponent is also going to be eliminated. Otherwise, you're going to be a detriment to your team, and the opposing team is just going to be handed a nice, easy win. And it's all going to be your fault. So, to ensure that you manage to win your 1v1s, you have to make sure that you're constantly aware and paying attention to what's going on both below and above you at any chance you get. So guys, let me tell you this, a great habit to really get into is just really watching pro players like Clicks and Day, you know, play wagers. And so you could just see exactly how they manage to apply pressure. And they're going to like usually do this by like spraying others to keep their teammates ahead of everybody. Basically, to apply pressure, you have to have the confidence and skills to play aggressively and be smart enough to know when, you know, you've pushed up a little bit too far and really disengage instead. You should be constantly trying to apply pressure, because if you take the pressure off somebody, they're going to easily be able to retreat and then link up with their teammates and then go for an easy elimination on you. So applying pressure on your teammates in fights is going to give your teammates the upper hand. You know, it's kind of like third partying a completely different fight, and you're always going to allow you to get ahead, you know, if you do this correctly. When it comes to any Fortnite game mode, guys, your overall mechanics and aim are obviously the most important fundamentals that you need to work on to win, right? Zone Wars is no exception to that, guys. Like, you know, you also need to throw amazing teamwork into the mix along with the two basic fundamentals. You can have the absolute best piece control, right? I mean, you can have the best aim in the world, but it's not gonna help you, you know, if you split off from your teammates and get caught off guard trying to be some sort of solo hero. So to avoid something like that, guys, like you should be practicing daily with your teammates. And by doing this, you're gonna be able to work on key strategies and really build up your communication skills. And when you find yourself in a negative situation, like losing your 1v1s or disengaging too early, you could end up costing the team your game. So instead of finding yourself in a situation like that, don't be shy to ask for assistance from a teammate, or even better, just stick right next to them from the beginning. So as you play more and more, you're going to be able to notice how your own mechanics and their mechanics, you know, is going to be able to work well together. And you're going to have chemistry to take people down. And hey, you know, if you're looking for the best ways to get better at concepts like peace control, aiming, or your overall mechanics, then you got to check out ProGuys.com, where we have thousands of guides and resources ranging from masterclasses to vibe reviews to 24/7 coaching that can really help you guys be the best. All right, ProGuys family, bunch of Crunch Army. We're going to do a quick recap. Here we go. Zone Wars is all about having amazing teamwork and having the best mechanics possible. Getting better in the mode is all about playing efficiently, playing to your team's strengths, and overall improving your Fortnite abilities. So make sure to keep all of your tips and tricks in mind and keep on practicing, guys. Keep going, keep grinding, never quit, never surrender, never give up on your dream. Bunch of Crunch Army, I love you guys. We're a family. I'm your motivation guy, and I'll see you soon.